Warm welcome as I welcome each one of you to 10 on FM presents the Economic Times Strategic Facilities Management Summit 2019, powered by CLR and brought to you by ET Edge. Well, the Economic Times second Strategic Facilities Management Summit will bring together leading stakeholders in the FM value chain who are overall management of building, operations, maintenance, and other support services. So I'd like to welcome each and every one of you and make sure this is going to be an opportunity for us to learn from the leaders of the industry. And now to join us for our keynote address on changing face of facilities management industry in the country, ladies and gentlemen, may I request all of you to please put your hands together and welcome Mr. Angad Rajan, Global IFM Head, 10 on FM.
It gives me immense pleasure to be with you here today at the second Economic Times Strategic Facility Management Initiative, which is an initiative which is very close to my heart in terms of what they do and what they goal aspire to achieve. Now, to understand what's changing in the facility management space, the changing phase, it's important to understand what are the changes and what's driving us to the change. So my first one I'll speak about is technology. We're going to speak about this all day. It's a disruptive force, it's fantastic, and technology will bring visibility, transparency, trust, and more importantly, clear insights of what should I do. Should I run my office from 9 to 6? Should I run my office from 10 to 4? What is the best optimal way for me to run my facilities today? That's where technology has to be integrated. The end user, which is our employees, which deliver our service, to the last man on the ground, the housekeeper, the technician who's delivering the service, has to be unified. But keep in mind, technology does not come free. So our aspirations of doing it low cost or no cost is not going to be fulfilled. The other part which I'll mention is around economic trends, and this is, you know, a big advantage for India for the last 5 years, and I suspect it'll be for the next 5 years as well. India is growing as a nation. The economy has been doing quite well, quite resilient, and with some hiccups, we'll still continue to do well. Our people are spending more time. We've become more urban. We're spending more time at cinema halls. We're spending more money on Amazon, Swiggy. We're getting comfortable of selling our used and cars at Cars 24 or whatnot. And we're also spending more time at malls and at work because our workspaces have evolved and become much better. And keep in mind that by 2025, 40% of India's population is going to be living in urban India, not rural. And they will be powering 80% of our GDP. That's money. That's the game changer. The next part which I'll speak about is regulatory perspective on our industry, which is the most important and crucial part which we can't control. Government's very active, which is both good and bad, as you all know. They're making a lot of changes. The Supreme Court ruling on Provident Fund or the ESI rate reduction. The only problem is that the good part is that they're making these changes, bringing transparency and control. The bad part is they provide little insight into how should we implement these changes in our businesses. As I've told you, all these changes that are happening in facility management, I want to caveat one bit. As the industry evolves from here on for the next 5 years, it's not the biggest or the strongest who will survive. It's the one who are agile and who can adapt. Because guess what? Your business has to be agile and adapt to deal with 50 minimum wage increases, with constantly changing portfolio, with co-working space in your portfolio. You have to evolve and agile. And if you're not that, you'll get left behind. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for the time.
We will now be starting with our opening C-level panel discussion, focusing on leadership perspective and strategic role of FM today in organizations' core business and contribution to its bottom line. May I request each and every one of you to please put your hands together for our moderator, a designer, a hotelier, an adventurer, an entrepreneur, Mr. Jimmy Mistry, Chairman and Managing Director, Della Group.
Let us begin this session with understanding where the management perspective on where the FM industry is today. And I would like to start with Brian. Brian, you've been in India for about a decade. And so what is your take on the current situation as far as a management perspective is concerned, of course, and the hardcore facility managers can talk about pure FM services industry. What is your take on the current situation of facility management in India? Last 2 years, we all realize and acknowledge the fact that real estate industry has not really been up there and had its own set of challenges across. Now, and FM is completely directly related to the real estate industry. In your case, it's the digital space, it's the retail space. So what is your take on the situation of FM industry in India today?
Well, like you said, I've been in India for a little over 9 years now. And certainly over the last, I would say, 7 years, to my experience, as it relates to my business, we have seen the professionalism increase every year. And now the way our facilities are managed, the way the response time is there, the prices that we know we pay that are fair, are extremely professional, very above board, and you know, it's critical. And we've gone from waiting a while or not getting done right to just a whole different world. Obviously, still there's, you know, progress to be made, but to me, it's a night and day difference from when I first came.
How do you see the industry today, and what is the future kind of in the near short term?
So I'll tell you from our perspective, we've gone beyond repair of air cons and repair of bulbs. For us, facility management is not just maintenance anymore. We consider ourselves as part of the senior management while running offices for our clients, wherein we are now responsible for actually retaining talent. And when I say retaining talent means you're building nice offices for your clients, you're managing those clients, you're looking and creating an experience for those employees so that clients are able to retain their employees.
What is your take on it?
I agree with both of them, and I would just like to mention one thing. See, if we talk about any service business, we're talking about three different angles. On one hand, we have the customer. On the other hand, we have the service provider. And more importantly, probably, we have a service scape, where the service is delivered, where the interaction happens, where the encounter happens. And if you really see, what Brian said is basically we have changed. We have changed over the last decade. We have been changing, and I think that's a constant thing. So all these three factors are changing. We have seen a lot of changes happen with the service providers. We have seen a lot of changes happen with the customers, with their expectations, with their demands, and also the participation. And if we talk about the service scape, I think all of us would agree to that. I mean, who ever imagined these kind of malls, these kind of offices, this kind of infrastructure in our country probably 2 decades back? So I guess all these changes somewhere are converging together to improve that service as a whole. So holistically speaking, I agree with Rajesh 100%. I mean, people, ultimately it's the people that deliver the business because we are in the service business. So even that is changing, and it's a big, big impetus for the industry to improve, to get further.
So, Jimmy, please go on.
Rajesh said a very good point about FM is responsible for retaining talent. And, you know, when I see across the industry and the FM managers who were earlier the support departments maybe a few years back, today they are driving business and responsible for the key value propositions that on which the organization stands. So it's no longer about changing bulbs, it's about supporting the business.
So what's your take? Because quite a few large organizations have set up their own divisions to handle their multiple facilities that they hand over, so there's a seamless integration. I'm sure you have a very different perspective from just being a pure service provider to a service provider to which is an ancillary to the large group.
So I think to add to all what my friends have already said, FM leaders today are not backbenchers anymore. They are walking with the developers and handling them and understanding expectations of the clients. More so working with the leaders of the industry and organizations which appoint them and ensuring an experience of wellness, of efficiency, and ensuring that there's a less amount of attrition in the companies.
So my friend here is from the hospital industry, Hinduja Hospital. What is your perspective in terms of the current situation of the facility management industry?
Jimmy, I have to say this from the hospital perspective. Facility management is a hidden aspect. People kind of ignore that in a hospital. That is probably one of the most crucial elements. So there are levels of service of all kinds needed in the hospital. So my request to all the your fellow colleagues in the industry when I meet them, I said, I am asking you to reduce the number of people, reduce the cost, but I'm not asking you to reduce the service. So please give me utopia. So that's my expectation.
I guess with this, we come to an end to the session. I hope you all have enjoyed the session as much as we've enjoyed conducting the session. And I'm really, really thankful to all the gentlemen on stage with me. There are some very eminent personalities within the field of facility management and their respective businesses taking out their prime time and coming and sharing their ideas and knowledge with us. I hope you take back home some of it. Thank you.
We are now about to begin with our next segment, which is Factors Driving the Growth of Facility Management in India. And to present the same, we have with us Mr. Jayal Doshi, Vice President, Business and Strategy, CLR Facility Services.
It's an honor and privilege for me to stand out here in front of you, our distinguished guests and leaders, and share some thoughts on the factors driving the growth of FM in India. The FM market in India has grown at about 370% from FY12 and currently at about 2.59 billion. The transition shift has been right from the core of hard and soft services, went down to the strategic fit of sustainable services in FM and energy management, and today we talk about experience. It used to be a glitzy breadwinner segment with more than 30% of the soft revenues from the soft services generated were earned by the large size establishments having a pan-India presence. There has been an excessive dependence on the capex of facilities, and today, when about 40 to 50% of the cost are related to FMS, this industry directly adds to the bottom line. In a nutshell, this transformation from a facility management, then we saw integrated facility management, then we went down to green integrated facility management, and today we talk about workplace solutions, is pioneered by digital transformation and robotic process automation, wherein on high usage could automate 70% of your steps and processes. Having said that, now let's understand the future potential of the market. India FM market grew at about 24% between FY12 and FY13. The FMS market is estimated to be at about 8 billion by FY23, which translates to about approximately about 5 million plus jobs in industry. This definitely calls for some serious labor reforms. With this, I end my thoughts, and thank you very much for your patience and your time.
About to begin a very special segment of the evening. This is going to be a moment that we would like to congratulate all those of you who've created a difference in your journeys when it comes to the facility management industry. May I please request all of you to welcome on stage Mr. Samuel Ebenezer, Project Director, ET Edge, for the unveiling of the Champions of Facility Management Coffee Table Book. Sam, may I request you to please do the honors. A round of applause as we now present to you The Economic Times Champions of Facility Management Coffee Table Book. And I'd like to request you to please stay on stage. As we begin with our felicitations in the category of Champions of FM in upcoming FM companies, I'd like to request all of you to please put your hands together for Astute Outsourcing Services. Now, I'd like to move on to our next category, which is that of Champions of FM in upcoming FM companies. And may I request all of you to please put your hands together for CLR Facility Services. Congratulations. It's now time for us to move on to our next category, which is that of Champions of Facility Management and IoT Solutions. May I request all of you to please put your hands together for Cognizant. Champions of FM in real estate industry, we've all been talking about it, and I'd like to request all of you to please put your hands together for Embassy Services. May I now request all of you to please put your hands together for Champions of FM in Smart Facility Solution, and I'd like to welcome the team from Facilio on stage. Security security is a very integral part of facility management, and that is what brings us to our next category, Champions of FM in Integrated Security. A round of applause for G4S. Taking the Walk of Fame in our next category, that of Champions of FM and Software Solutions, is Plenon. This brings us to our next category, that of Champions of FM in Sustainable Facility Management, and we'd like to wish the very best to Team Sodexo India. Now, I'd like to move on to our next category, which is that of Champions in Indian IFM Companies. And may I request all of you to please welcome the team from Tenon Facility Management. I'd now like to welcome on stage Champions of FM and Network Solutions to Improve Security. Please welcome Access Communications. Mr. Ebenezer, I'd like to request you to please stay on for another moment. We would love to have each one of you with those very proud trophies to join us here on stage for a group picture. I'd like to thank you all for joining us, for your time. Thank you for being a part of the Economic Times Strategic Facility Management Summit.
Business and facility management have evolved quite a bit. The traditional approach was more reactive, where employee experience didn't really matter or wasn't really an important part of what was important for a facility manager. However, now the reactive approach has changed into proactive approach. People are now seriously looking at how can we enhance the employee experience. And there's a clear reason for that, because business has understood that there is a direct link between how do employees experience their workplace and how is their performance and productivity, and most importantly, will they stay in the organization. And this is how business has started to understand and work very closely with service partners and providers like us in finding ways how we can enhance the employee experience, be it how can we smooth out the process of them arriving at the firm through transportation or the experience of providing a clean office, how do we provide food services, and many other features. So that's broadly, if I say, employee experience has now become an essential part of being an important facility management partner to any business. Now, if we continue to use the old way of operating facility management or the infrastructure, we'll end up in a place where the facilities are, you know, more boxed up, more cubical. There's not as much collaboration. And this generation needs collaboration. It needs a break every 1 hour. So that's a statistic that we did an assessment that every 1 hour, a millennial will get up and take a 5-minute break before he gets back to work. So if we don't use and understand these analytics, if we don't start planning for it, there will be no predicting. We'll always be reacting. We'll always be chasing out to, you know, employees and partners to save them from being poached over by a competitor. We'll always be investing more and more on onboarding new talent, which, as we know, is a big cost for any business to onboard and retain a talent. So the three topics that I felt were very powerfully covered during the sessions in the ET Summit were technology, what is the impact, what do we do about it, co-working space, and planning for the future. These are a lot of things which are burning questions for us as business leaders, as partners.
Today, the industry is paying people based on minimum wages. We need to move from minimum wages to fair wages in order to attract and retain good talent. We also have thousands of people working in this industry. We need to identify the talent and upskill them. Great investment is required in skill development. We are taking a couple of initiatives at CLR to do so.
There has been a consolidation in, you know, the vendor base of companies. because there are companies in BFSI and, you know, banking sector, we have, there are multiple sites. They own around 2,000 sites, 1,000 sites with multiple assets around their, you know, locations. And they earlier had multiple vendors at these locations. So this, they are looking for a strategic partner, you know, to work on a pan-India basis and who has presence in most of the cities. And so they are taking this well. So I think we will see more consolidation, and that helps us to invest also more in, you know, in this kind of partnership when it comes to technology, when it comes to equipment, and when it comes to infrastructure as a whole. So I think companies are taking well in this manner. Yeah.
A facility manager is no more a person who is taking a back seat and who is not seen and, you know, doing his service. He is somebody who understands the business, who understands the nitty-gritties, what is going behind the scene, and he is seen on the floor, and he is about experience. And he is part of the strategy, he is part of decision making, and it is like how to retain people. So when we work with the clients, we work with them on how we will enable you to retain your people, how we will enable you to focus on your core, and your non-core becomes my core. So that is something which we are working on. And technology here plays a very, very important part, because all the tools and tackles and technology helps us to achieve what we have not been doing in the previous years. So that is a big change again.
I genuinely believe that technology is a big differentiator in terms of improving efficiencies, bringing in some kind of number crunching, and, you know, bringing in a better experience in this industry. But only if it is used correctly, and all the data that is gathered is used to analyze and go into a predictive mode rather than a preventive mode. So we at Embassy Services strongly believe in technology. What we've done is we've built a robust technology platform, but we've kept one mantra in our game very clear. We say that just keep it simple. So we've not tried to overachieve. We are going in milestones. We are treading very safely. We are going into platforms where we understand that it's usable, user-friendly, and it's needed by the client, which is most important, and not just kept at the back end and to showcase it as something which is being done but not really used.
If you look at the video surveillance industry as such, it generates a lot of video. When you have a lot of video, then you need to manage it either in a forensic form or you need to basically manage it in a proactive form. In a forensic form, what happens? It is very manual. You need to basically go through the entire video streams to see what happened. It can be very time consuming and very difficult as well. Whereas in the proactive systems, when you run analytics both in the edge of the camera or a server-based analytics, you can take proactive actions. So we see that the analytics basically in the edge is really helping bring down the manual errors in the video surveillance in our systems.
I think over the period of time, FM space has not been just limited to the physical environments. I think more than physical environments, now we move to, you know, reimagined work as we put together. So it is not just physical environment. And in fact, it is not just the tangible assets that we work with. It is both tangible and intangible assets that bring in the total work experience that the person takes. So tangible assets such as the workplace, and the intangible assets such as the culture and the policies of the company. Now it is on the organization and, you know, with the help of a partner like Sodexo, so how we bring together and weave all the elements together, both tangible and intangible, and deliver that overall workplace experience. Another thing which is very important for delivering the optimal efficiency and well-being for a consumer is designing the workplace in a very emotional, intelligent manner. Right. So when we say emotionally intelligent workplace, from the past few decades, I think now the workforce has transformed itself. And when I enter into an office today, and I don't enter as a professional, I enter as a person. So I expect my workplace to respect as a human who I am and cater to the personal needs that I have, no matter what caste, gender or age that I am. No matter what skills that I bring in, I expect the workplace to contain all the requirements or all the expectations that I have from my workplace. That gives the employee a good experience so that they can inspire, learn, invent, and, you know, lead in a certain fashion. Technology plays a very important role in enabling the right workplace experience, because you basically map out the whole experience and you plan the right intervention where you can actually optimize the overall experience of the consumer, and technology becomes a key lever to gather the right data, to be more agile in delivering the work, in the workplace experience. And not only that, you can actually churn out various solutions in a short amount of time to be optimally placed in front of an employee.
Facility management is moving from the backyard to the front yard. It's moving from an ancillary function in management to one of the most important and critical functions in management. It's the backbone of any large organization. Facility management dwells into multiple areas. It's no longer about engineering services and housekeeping. It's into multiple areas. And most critical thing is it dwells between HR and finance, because the entire budgeting of the organization's operational budget is handled by the FM head.